What's up, guys? Back at the stadium. Yay! I know I was kind of complaining when the 10-game homestand ended because I needed a break, and I did. It's been nice not having to go to, like, a game every single day for the past few days. But I'm so happy to be back. Freeway series starts tonight, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then it's the All-Star break. We've got a couple All-Stars. We have Matt Kemp starting. Kenley Jansen is also an All-Star. And Ross Stripling made it, which is really cool because he deserved it. And he should have been put on sooner than having to wait, I think, for John Lester to not be able to be there due to him pitching he's pitching within the next couple days, so he can't pitch at the All-Star game. But so congratulations to them for making the All-Star team. Super cool. We tried to get Max Muncy in with the final vote. Unfortunately, it did not end up working, but he will be representing us in the Home Run Derby, so that is super cool. I'm super excited about that. Really quickly, some news we've got going on is today Chase Utley called for a press conference, and he officially announced that at the end of the 2018 season, he will be retiring. So this is officially Chase Utley's last season as a baseball player. He's got about 2 months left. He said a big part of it was he's tired of being a part-time dad and wants to spend more time with his kids. So that's totally understandable, especially when you've been in the game for, I think it's 16 years now. He said his kids constantly ask him when he's going to be able to not go to the field anymore, when he can just stay home. So I think it's seemed like he was happy and seemed like he made the right decision for himself. And so at the end of the day, no matter what I think or what anyone else thinks about his performance and what he's currently doing for the team, he's happy. So that's all that matters. So good for him. And I'm sure his kids are going to be stoked. It sounded like he hasn't told them yet. So I'm sure they will be very happy to know that they will get to spend a lot of time with their dad. So right now we've got Forsyth and, I mean, Utley's still on the team, still playing. So we've still got our second baseman. I think once a week is what Robert said. Tonight, Kike's actually playing, which is nice. Forsyth has been kind of pissing everyone off, I think. To put it nicely, he just is a disaster right now with the bat. Even his defense has fallen off. I'm hoping that if they trade for Machado, no matter who they trade for, I'm hoping they can convince another team to just take him so we don't have to have him anymore. He's a free agent after this year, so it's really going to be just trying to convince a team to take his salary, if anything. It's not like they have to commit to him for years on end, so Dodgers may have to throw in another prospect in order to get him to another team, so hopefully they can make that happen. Because right now we're in talks for Manny Machado when it comes to the offense, so we could see how that would go. I wouldn't mind Scooter Gennett. He seems pretty good, having a pretty good season, and he's actually a second baseman. But Manny Machado's bat would be huge. We can just move Kike over to second base, Barnes, Taylor, and Manny Machado can play shortstop. So obviously we're all waiting to kind of hear back on that. But tonight we have game one against the Angels. Walker Buehler's back. So pretty happy to have him back. He's making his first start since he got pulled a while back. Got hurt for the fractured rib, made his appearance against the Cubs, I think it was 2 weeks ago, and just got lit up coming out of the bullpen. So it'll be good to see him back on the mound tonight. But I've got on, also so you guys see it, I've got on my favorite shirt for when we play the Angels, just because they have a hard time knowing where they're at on a map. So I'm here early, as always, gonna head up for BP soon, see how the guys are looking, see how the team's kind of going after Utley announced his retirement. I kind of feel like it could spark the team. They'll definitely probably be wanting to play for him, especially players like Kike. It means a lot to him. So we'll see how things go tonight, and gotta come out with that win. Oh, and we're in first place by half a game, so gotta keep winning. Don't want to lose that first place spot again. Out here for BP. Pitchers are doing BP, then we'll get to see the position players up next. Robert's son. A lot of the kids are out here now that it's summer. It's kind of cool. Some of them can make pretty good plays. There's the position players and pitchers. Some of the pitchers.
BP's over. They looked pretty good today. A couple of the guys were, Matt Kemp was just like nonstop out there his last round or two. A couple of the other guys were hitting them hard, but not hard enough that they were going out. So hopefully they're just, I mean, it's BP, so it's not like they have to hit a home run every time. It looked like a lot of them were working on going opposite field and hitting line drives, which I will always prefer anyways. It's nice when they can get singles and doubles to drive home runs, not just home runs. So we will see how this game goes. I have a good feeling though. They're undefeated at home so far in July. I think that's only like four games, but whatever. They scored a bunch of runs against the Pirates when they were here last, so hopefully they can keep it up against the Angels. It should be a pretty packed game tonight. There's a lot of people, as you can see. A lot of people on the field right now for BP. Angels are just about to start. So just going to wait for the game to get started. It starts in about 2 hours. And then after all this time, I think it's been probably about a month, month and a half since I caught my last BP ball. But I caught one. And it's a Matt Kemp one. I haven't caught a Kemp one all season. I've got a couple Kemp ones, but I did not catch them on the fly. This one I caught on the fly, so I'm pretty excited about it. And it's got the 60th anniversary logo. Looks almost brand new too. I'm trying to show you. Come on, too close, yeah. Only marks it's got is back here, which looks like it's off his bat, the blue. So I don't know if he has a blue bat, I should probably look, but it's a couple blue marks on it actually. So it's not just off him. A couple other guys might've hit it first, or probably did. So I'm pretty excited about that. But other than that, just gonna wait here. Right now, Turner is day to day. He hurt his, I think it was his adductor when he check swung the other night against the Padres. So he's not playing tonight. They did say he's available to pinch hit, but right now he's day to day. So once I hear more information on that, I'll make sure to let you guys know. Dodgers are currently losing 2-1. Muncy's home run is the only run so far for the Dodgers. Cole Calhoun took Buehler deep twice. So two solo shots for him was the only run for the Angels. Both teams only have 6 hits. The Dodgers really haven't been able to do much, unfortunately. Buehler had a pretty good outing except for the 2 home runs, but for his first start back in about almost a month, not too bad, can't really complain. Or maybe it's been, no, more than a month. So hopefully the offense can get it together, score us a couple more runs, and we can come out of here with a win tonight. We've got Forsythe on deck for, he's gonna bat for Caleb Ferguson, who came in relief for, I believe, 2 innings. So let's get some runs.
Top of the knife, Dodgers are up by 1. And they announced in the Dodgers beat him.
Dodger fans booed him, obviously. A little bit of that bad blood back from when they wanted the Dodgers wanted to sign him. Oh.
Bellinger made a good play at first to tag the guy running. Now we get to enjoy some fireworks. I'm a mess right now. Woo. All right. Woo!